SSHFS is another alternative to NFS and SMB. It allows you to mount remote storage locations on your system, and it works through SFTP, which in turn works through SSH. Therefore, for most operating systems, the SSHFS setup only requires starting an SSH server. That sounds almost too good to be true, and in a way it is. There are multiple aspects to SSH security and many potential pitfalls. One of the key elements for secure communication is the verification of the other party's authenticity. However, the only way an SSH client can do this verification step is by storing the public keys of every SSH server that it has connected to in the past. That brings us to the fact that RouterOS is designed to be compatible with older devices that have very small 16 megabyte storage chips. While it has SSH client built in for convenience, it does not store the public keys of SSH servers in what would be the known host's file on other systems. This does not mean that an SSH connection to your router is insecure. When you connect from your computer, you are the client and you are performing the security check using your known host's file. But when you want your router to act as a client that connects to another device through SSH, SFTP or SSHFS, make sure that you are doing it either on a completely isolated network or at least on an otherwise very safe network, as you might be opening the door for a man-in-the-middle attack. That being said, SSHFS is a super convenient file exchange method. You can set it up on your router to access storage on another router's device or on some other operating system. For the demonstration, I will set it up between two CHRs. They are both in my computer, so it is one of the safe use cases for this feature. First, I want to note the IP address of the second CHR that I will be accessing. Then on the first CHR, I can go to the disk section and enter add type SSHFS. Now, there are several SSHFS parameters, but since we are logging into another CHR with no password and user admin, we are only going to need the IP. And for convenience, we also want to specify a short name with the slot property. It should then just show up on your disk section and the file section. To test it, we can create a file in our new SSHFS1 location. As you can see, it got saved, and on the other CHR, it is simply stored in the main storage location. If we had to navigate a more complex file path, we could have simply used the SSHFS path property. Okay, but let's say that we want to access files on our router from a Linux machine. In this case, our other device is acting as the client, and we will be checking and storing the router's host key at their end. A typical setup would look something like this. First, make sure you have the SSHFS package installed. Then we can create a folder where we can mount the remote storage location. After that, you should be able to run the SSHFS command. If you are connecting for the first time to your router, you might be asked to verify the fingerprint of your router's public SSH key. Just type yes. That will save the host key. If you ever manually change the SSH host key on your router, new SSH connections from this machine will fail until you manually update the known host file. Now, if we check our mount folder, we can see the my file that we created earlier. Let's try adding another file called my second file. Then if we check the files on our router, the new file should be there too. Thank you for watching and stay safe.